Today's podcast is brought to you by Audible.com. Get a free audiobook download at audiblepodcast.com/sorgatronmedia. Over 75,000 titles to choose from for your iPod, iPhone, or MP3 player.
Just wait, just wait, just wait, just wait. Wait for the perfect time, then attack. Don't give up what you want, take it back. Wait for the perfect time, then attack.
Hey guys, Wrestling Mayhem Show 280. We are back again, and this is the show where everybody's replaceable.
Everyone.
Everybody.
Every one of you motherfuckers is replaceable.
You forgot for a second that this is the one you can swear on. Uh-huh. Yes. Yes. With me is my faithful compatriot, heterosexual life mate. Wow, that all came out wrong.
That came out wrong.
Chachi!
Hi, guys. Came out all right.
Happy wrestling!
What?
I said happy wrestling.
That really lingered off a little bit.
I know.
Okay. All right. And from the Bronx, New York, the big bad Bronx, Mad Mike.
Balls.
I was looking at your place on Google Earth earlier.
Ooh.
What's up?
I don't know. I was looking at your place
he
on Google
Earth. He was stalking you.
Yeah.
He's on Street View.
That's where Mike lives.
Looking in your house.
What are you doing? What are you doing with your hands?
I hope they gave you a good show.
Okay, how you doing, man?
I'm doing excellent. I am employed. I have a job, Sorgatron.
Good, because I wasn't paying you anytime soon.
Yeah, I know. That's what I figured. I'm like, well, Sorg's gonna be fucking.
I hope you weren't
about the whole.
I hope you weren't holding down for that Mayhem Show check.
Wait.
You know what? I figured if I bounce the basketball 10 times. I would get my big motherfucking Mayhem check, but you just kicked the ball out of 9, Sorg.
Yep.
That's right. I Virgiled you. And also from the Flood City, Bobby FJPGH J-Town, whatever your thing is now. I haven't ever changed this. We'll fix
J-Town.
That. We'll fix that.
J-Town.
How you doing?
J-Town.
How you doing? Are you wet?
Whoa. I'm not wet.
Hey,
that's the first question. That's the first question you asked from Jim.
Watch what you're asking him.
Sorgatron,
that crossed the line.
I'm scared now.
Are you drunk? Can you turn my mic up some?
Actually, no, I'm going to stay away from steroids so I can stay on the show.
That's good. We do have a steroid problem on this show. We have a steroid and Pop Rocks problem on this show. That's why there's all different people this week. Also, from wherever the hell he's from in the city, Rizz.
Yes.
How you doing?
Hi. I am wet.
Whoa.
Ladies. Wow. Well, ladies.
There is so a gentlemen. Line, and you guys are crossing it.
You guys
it.
Aren't far enough over the line, is what's going
scared.
On here. fantastic. We got a crew. We're excited about wrestling. That's what this show is about, is 280 times we've sat here and talked about wrestling and been mostly happy about it.
Yes.
Except for when we're talking about today. Except for when Sting's champion. Which is now.
Yes.
Anyways, but it's, you know, we talk about the stuff we love, which is wrestling, and we do it together across the nation.
We're friends.
You can participate, my friends.
Yes,
participate.
You can.
Over at WrestlingMayhemShow.com, where you find out more about us. If you stumbled on this by accident, you can tweet us at Mayhem Show, and if you're on the video version, you'll see all of our Twitter accounts to yell at us personally on why we're wrong.
Tweet.
Yes, you can.
Chachi's wrong.
You can also send us an email at this fine email address of
Good Times.
That's right, Good Times at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Or you can phone us at 412-206-WMS0. That's also 9670. You can also contact us on where's my iPhone?
I don't know.
Hold on, let me get my dealie.
I got on the iPhone.
I have my dealie.
He has a dealie. No, we're fine. Okay. There's also this handy dandy Wrestling Mayhem Show app you can buy for $1.99 on the iOS or Android stores, and also on the Amazon store as well. There, Mad Mike up in the Bronx has it on his iPod Touch, I believe.
Yes.
And what that gets you is fast access to all those modes of communication, as well as the show archive, and some bonus content that you can't see anywhere else unless you're joining us live right here on Tuesday nights
at 8:30
p.m. Eastern Time at live.sorgatronmedia.com. So go check that out. Support the show and easy access. I know AJ does it. AJ's listening to this right now.
Hi, AJ.
On Wednesday morning when he listens to the show.
Hi, AJ.
And he's also and we're about to say something really funny that's going to make him laugh and almost get fired by his boss.
Wait. This is a message from past Chachi to future AJ. send me a message on Twitter that says, Bo Diggity, when you diggity. Hear this.
And in case you forgot, that's how Chachi says. You're going to get tweets from everybody throughout the week saying, Bo Diggity.
Bo Diggity.
Bo Diggity.
That's fantastic. Everybody tweet them. Go ahead and do it. Anyways. Well,
I'll retweet, you'll retweet every single one of them.
You also have stickers. Where's my stickers at?
I ate them.
You ate the stickers? Oh, yes. Yeah. Here's some of
Wednesday
them.
Is Bo Diggity Day.
Wait, Chachi, how do you spell Bo Diggity?
Be inventive. But these are the stickers. You can send a sassy to us.
Sassy.
Email for details on that, or it's over on the website.
Boom.
For your Wrestling Mayhem show. Stickers. They're free.
I have stickers like a Chewbacca belt.
There you go. Anyways, the stickers are good.
Stickers are awesome.
Bo Diggity is spelled.
So we like this. Oh, you're gonna tell us how to spell Bo Diggity.
Sorg.
Yes, sir.
Sorg. If someone sends you a sassy to get some WMS stickers, and then they go to either a WWE or a TNA show, doesn't matter, it can be a house show, and they post some stickers up, and they take pictures of where those stickers are and the ticket for the event that they're going to.
Okay.
And send them to us at good times, they'll get a special prize.
Yes, of some choosing of ours.
Yes.
All right.
Hypothetical DVD player. Yay.
What?
You get Chachi's shoe.
You can't
and
have
put it on
shoe.
His head.
We will pick up random stuff here in the studio, which is bad considering where we put the studio.
Yes.
So.
Anyhow, mm-hmm. Bo Diggity, me, O, 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 O. D I G G I T Y. Bo Diggity.
That seems
like the way you work it. Bo Diggity.
That doesn't
booty.
Seem right at all. No, anyways.
That is Bo Diggity. You gotta extend the.
Bobby, did you just make a Black Street reference?
Yes, I did.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
I get the streets unlocked.
No doubt.
Fired.
We do have fan mail. We like to start off with what you guys have told us. Unfortunately, some of the fan mail is from people on the show. So we're going to skip those. No, we're not going to skip those. What we are going to do is address a concern by somebody that's been on the show before. AJ at AJPGH.
Yeah. PGH. Bo Diggity AJ.
Bo Diggity AJ. Bo Diggity AJ. Yes, this is all true. None of this is false. I lost his email. I'm so sorry.
Oh, no.
I completely lost his email.
I'm just having fun. Anytime you mention AJ in this episode,
I'm Bo Diggity AJ.
Bo Diggity AJ.
Bo Diggity.
The secret word is AJ.
AJ has always wanted a nickname. Can we just start calling him Bo Diggity?
Bo Diggity.
Bo Diggity.
Listen here, Bo Diggity. Listen here, Bo Diggity. Somebody tweet him that he's now...
Bo Diggity. Bo, if you're nasty.
Oh, God. Oh, we need to move on. Please,
Mr.
let's stop.
Bo,
let's move
if you're
on.
Nasty.
Okay, somebody else read an email, and then I'll address this.
Okay, I have Pierre Calais. Ha, 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 ha.
Okay.
To the WMS Nation. Triple H was taking over the whole company like Hogan did in TNA, and he decided to intentionally get rid of Michael Cole for making sure they needed a better broadcast booth and instead getting JR to replace him. But Coleslaw eventually lost to Zack Ryder in just 30 seconds to have him back on TV after 4 months of not having his time. But Rey Mysterio captured the spinner belt when all of a sudden, John Cena took it away quickly. This was to crown the vacant WWE champion. Whoever, after Super Cena yet won another title, something drastic happened. It was CM Punk with Living Colors, Cult of Personality, blaring in the background. Good thing he ditched the kill switch engage like Jimmy D. Papa did for Jimmy Hart in the WCW music department back then.
What the hell?
He's
what?
I don't understand.
I'm not sure.
All right, roll with it.
Okay. He showed the WWE spinner belt he won, and they have two spinner belts. Ever since Ric Flair came into WWE in 1991, what in the name of Magnum TA did two wrestlers with similar belts appear on Raw? I'm guessing CM Punk came back because he didn't want to be retired. but we'll see up until SummerSlam. Thanks, and I'll see you later. Pierre K, a.k.a. Mr. Techwood Drive.
Can I... Let's go back.
Okay. All right. Talk first to
off, first off...
Yes. Yes.
If you insinuate one more time that JR is a bad announcer, I will hunt you down and shove...
You should slap him.
I don't...
We know where you live.
You should slap him via email.
Yes, I will. I will do something. And then what else did I want to address? Nope, that was it. All right, just that in that email. Although, we'll wait.
Okay.
Let's finish the email first.
I do have... Wait, but that was the rest... That was finished, right?
Yeah, that one was done.
Okay. From AJ, he claims, and this is entitled Wrestle
Fan. Bo Diggity.
Bo Diggity.
I'm sorry. Wrestle Fan.
Bo Diggity.
That's right.
AJ.
He responds, "What the fuck is Wrestle Fan doing back? I thought he was Future Endeavor. Explain yourself." That's how it was written.
It's a legit.
And he's fine.
Yes,
it's
he lasted
legit,
a week.
It's
he
a legit
a
question.
He pulled a Marty Jannetty, and he's now on. He violated the wellness policy of the Wrestling Mayhem show. Me also, DJ Lunchbox has been suspended for a week for his pop rock addiction.
He was caught driving across the border with a trunk full.
He's just in a corner shaking.
Of pop rocks. Of pop rocks. Of pop, yes. Pop rocks.
This is all true.
Yes.
So, you know, that's how that's going to be.
Yep.
And we're not going to say more because our lawyers have warned us against that.
Yes.
And we're going to move on to
right.
New fan mail.
To the Rizz Mail!
That's right.
Hi.
WMS!
That's him.
CM Punk. Yay.
Yay. Pew, pew.
You know what? No, that pew, pew fits perfectly.
Okay, okay. he gets to add a commentary track, yes, to his own email. Okay, that's fine.
However,
you didn't know he's going to be on.
I'm not sure if anyone's going to notice or care, but there's a slight incident that I have. Yep, incident that I have with what took place last Monday. That thing is why only have 1 week of Punk doing whatever he want, whatever the hell he wants, without anything happening to him, because he was not quote unquote under contract. Other than that, I enjoyed every minute of the last segment of Raw. And for the record, I voiced that same concern with Sorg on the ride over here.
Mm-hmm.
I said it should have gone easily another week, week and a half,
okay,
before he came back.
I entirely disagree with that.
All right, we'll get into this.
All right, we'll get into it, but definitely disagree.
In other non-CM Punk is awesome news, Daniel Bryan has a YouTube channel now. It's called Mr. Bryan Danielson. Two things. He is about to cash the Money in the Bank briefcase against Zack Ryder on Z True Long Island Story. And will WWE shut down his YouTube station due to it being called Mr. Bryan Danielson and not Mr. Daniel Bryan? Until next time, you don't have to follow me. Only you can set you free. Yes, I sang that while typing it. Rizz. P.S. Let us have football so I can be champion in the Mayhem fantasy football.
Did you really sing that?
Yes, I really did.
Can you give us a rendition?
And it was
of
so.
That?
No, I will not.
That's a shame. It's a damn shame.
You are a performing monkey. You will dance. You will dance. You will sing, and you will dance when we tell you to.
What? What I do?
No, Rizz.
You didn't do anything, Chachi.
Okay, good.
So where's that dancing?
Rizz, sing.
Where's that dancing?
Dance.
Continue on with the email.
Dance.
Rizz is not allowed in Mayhem.
Dance.
Rizz is
dance,
not allowed
dance,
in Mayhem Fantasy Football
magic.
Until he sings.
Dance. Hey, I will turn this show around.
That's
you
right.
Dance.
That's right. He can do
dance.
That. He's dancing.
Dance
there is. He's
dancing.
All
you can
right.
Leave your friend behind.
That was great,
okay,
for audio people.
Right.
Let's move on.
You're welcome, audio.
Dear audio listeners, Rizz just did a dance.
By the way, I have tweeted that we now refer to AJ and PGH as Boo Diggity. That is all.
Bo Diggity.
Oh, this is going to be fun.
Bo Diggity.
Yes. Yes. I hope whatever he's doing, he got that tweet. Anyways,
hey.
We got another email here from Sean Burkhead.
We didn't.
It says no subject.
I'm kidding.
Sean Burkhead's back?
Yeah. Good evening, WMS Peeps. Wait, did he have an accent? Did we read this with an accent? No. I can't remember.
No.
No.
Good evening, WMS Peeps. As I blow the dust off the remember how my emails tend to go, what a week to return to the emailing of the best damn podcast out there, bar none.
Boom.
Oh, yeah.
Bo diggity.
Bogit diggity Sean Burkett. We just doubled it up. I was kind of surprised about how fast they had CM Punk return to Raw TV. Granted, I enjoyed Cult of Personality as Punk walks out. So looks like we have a title versus title match at SummerSlam. This is how sad the state of TNA is. I have missed the last 2 weeks and don't feel bad for not watching. I did order the last pay-per-view from then, but I knew it wouldn't last the pay-per-view. Austin Aries is great, and that is about it for my TNA talk. Dashing awesome Mike, Mad Mike, please include me in the fantasy football. Thanks, and have a great night, everyone. So, yeah, it's starting. Everybody, it is funny that the NFL came back and everybody's like, hey, Mayhem football. It's like, oh,
well, Sorg, right. To be fair, I did post on the fabulously awesome Facebook Wrestling Mayhem Show page.
Actually, I think you put it in the group.
Oh.
No one uses the group anymore.
I thought they're
the same thing now.
No, you're alone.
You're all alone.
All alone.
Forever alone.
I'm sorry, Mike. You're alone. Oh. All right, there's more email to make us more excited.
No,
please.
Woo! Yeah.
Sorry. Call
the first
thing.
Bo-diggity.
That was AON's theme.
Bo-diggity.
So much is happening.
I know that horrible music anywhere.
Oh, yes. Was there any more email, guys?
Sorg, do you want to talk about the Mayhem Fantasy Football League since two people brought it up in the email?
Not yet.
Is there much to talk about yet?
No.
Other than
I was just going to say that there is a super special secret prize that
there
I'm
is
going
a
to
super
flash in front of the camera right now.
Okay, we have really bad resolution on you, but that will be perfect to not
Wait,
disclose
it's a PG.
Completely.
I know what the prize is.
Wait, it's not your penis, is it?
Yes.
No, it
can't really show that.
Unless a lady wins.
I don't think we can even put that on just
It's my
TV.
Penis. My penis is a super secret.
Oh, there it is. There it is. Penis? There's something. It's a prize. It looks like it's made of paper.
It is made of paper. It is fancy. It is something that only someone in my position could have obtained.
Oh, shit.
Oh,
so there you go. We have a prize here for the Mayhem Football. You know, other than that, if you're interested in the Mayhem Football, like I said, email Mad Mike. You're compiling the list of people to contact. Is that correct?
Yes.
You are the orchestrator.
Pretty much everyone who was involved last year will automatically be contacted. But if anyone new wants to come in, it's a free league. It's a free league. We have a custom league. We have a live draft. And we usually talk a lot of shit on each other.
Yeah.
In the live
Already
draft.
Started.
if you want to piss off Chad the Shad, draft Drew Brees right before him.
Mm-hmm.
He loves that.
Yeah. Yeah.
But yeah, we talk a lot of shit during the live draft. I'll probably accept people coming in until I'm guessing maybe the week of August 20th. Before we start thinking about when the live draft is going to be.
Yeah, so we're on that
usually
list.
On weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Usually on a weekend, Sunday night, something like
we'll
that.
We'll have to do something fun, like do a Google Hangout or something for it.
Oh, that'll be fun.
Those have been pretty fun for Raw, I know. So.
The prize is a hypothetical penis.
That's right. Hypothetical penis. That's what we're playing for. The winner loses. Anyways, but no, if you guys want to get involved, it's a great chance. We do a lot of trash talking here on the show, on the Twitters, in your emails.
And you all are going to bow down and suck my nuts.
And usually the old-time Mayhem people were involved in it. The old Doc Remedy, you know, from Beyond
He's
the
dead.
Grave. And DJ Lunchbox and Mayhem Missy and all of them. Chad to Shad.
Is WrestleFan available to do this? Or is he? Under his contract?
If he passes a piss test, yeah, he can do this. So
okay,
all right. So there's.
I hope I get a better draft pick this year, though.
Oh yeah,
yeah. My draft pick blew last year.
Yeah. You remember last year, I did a live draft pick selection show on YouTube. Where I had every team represented by a different DVD.
Yeah.
And that was pretty interesting.
I was right in the middle.
I think I missed it. I had to work or something.
I was right
in
the middle.
It's on YouTube.
Yeah. I was right in the middle of the draft picks. So
weren't you first, Mad Mike?
Mike, what's your account that this is on?
No, I don't think Mike... No, Mike wasn't first.
No, I wasn't first. I got the last pick of round one.
Oh, okay.
But the first pick of round two.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, no, I was, like, right in the middle, so... It blew.
Anyways, let's see, WrestleFan's not here, and unfortunately with them goes a lot of the indie minutes. So what the AON minute is, Bobby...
We get a whole minute this time.
Actually, take a few.
Yeah, yeah. All right. No, don't take your time.
I'm going to take an hour. No,
tell us what's going on there, and I think I can get this video up for you.
Okay, this week on the show, they had the Red River Rebels in the studio. They showed the Psychotic Assassins versus the Red River Rebels. Manchild was in the match, and that's all you need to know.
Yeah, that's true.
Manchild.
John McGraw pissed Manchild off, and Manchild ripped his mask to reveal Angry Manchild. And then James Ford hit the H1N1, or the Swanton Bomb, off the top rope and missed, but he later capitalized to pick up a win on Ryan Fear. An AON magazine is going to be on sale at the shows.
What? Really? Yeah. They're doing a magazine?
Yeah, for real. Yeah, wow. They showed a picture of it.
Let's stop this for a second. AON, congratulations. You are officially more further along than TNA.
Yeah, yeah.
TNA doesn't have a magazine.
And Sting is not their champion. That's another step.
That's true.
War for Territory 4 will be held at the Manpo in Altoona on August 20th. And they said on the advertisement, if you do not attend the Manpo, you're not a man. And I quote.
That's tremendous.
The Red River, then they played the next match that they had, the Red River Rebels versus the Slip Into It Syndicate, or Coma Clayton and NJ Syndicate. The Syndicate picked up the victory with the Syndicate Slam. They go back to the studios where the Red River Rebels are pissed that that match was picked, and they back Drew Shannon into a corner. That's one of the hosts.
Okay.
They go to another video from ISP. The match between Colin Blair versus ISP is now for the rights of the dictatorship of the cartel. And if ISP loses, he will exile himself from AON.
Okay.
There's actually a promo from him on the video I sent. It starts at like 9 minutes in, I think. And at the end of the show, the Rebels attacked Terry, the assistant cameraman, for playing the match where the Rebels lost. They slammed him into a Goodwill collection bin outside of the studio, and that's how the show ended. And another thing, the Project 13 is actually, they had a really funny video this week where they took Nerf guns into Roaring Springs and were on the hunt for Kes Edison to try to find him and bring him back into the fold.
I think this is some of that.
So,
yeah.
And that concludes the AON report for this week.
Well, there you go. Thank you, Bobby. So no problem. I think that's all we really have indie wise. I say we're a little off because our indie person is too busy sniffing stuff up his nose in his college education. So
that was the closest minute we've ever got.
Yeah, a little bit. So here's a little peek at other stuff going on, and we'll be right back.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna bury everybody. Bury Shawn Michaels, even though he helped train me, and I'm gonna bury William.
Guys are affected by, but it is the one that I should. What the hell? That's racist. Whoa. That is racist as hell.
What?
Harold's audio. What audio?
Audio.
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 We say things.
Hi, everybody. This is the Rizz from the Wrestling Mayhem Show, and welcome back. First of all, and now we're going to do a little segment that everyone's been doing, except for me, until right now. And that is, remember when?
I love how everyone has the same way of saying, remember when?
Look,
it's just the old classic 90s sitcom thing where we all tilt our head and there's a little thought bubble.
Sorry, that's actually that's a good segue, actually. My remember when is, when during a wrestling match, you're watching it, and all of a sudden, there's this big, like a small square starting to like turn around and go in that left-hand corner of the screen. And it's that guy who's in the ring right now. yes. or another guy who's fighting him yes. or like cutting a promo while they're wrestling. Like, I remember watching that and thinking, this is cool. And like, it just showed that they actually did care about wrestling back then mm-hmm. because now you have these live, you know, moments where there's people in the back talking about God knows what. But back in the day, it's more, hey, I'm going to kick your ass. I'm going to bury you. And,
got a so, rawr.
Rawr. And, like, I remember watching Mr. Perfect and seeing his face pop up talking about how he wants to beat this guy or Bret Hart come on saying he's the best there is, best there was, best there ever there will be. And now I remember the last time I actually watched SmackDown. It's been a while, but they started to come back with that. And I'm pretty excited to see that again. So if you ever remember when, remember it. Maybe you'll be on the show.
Well said.
That was wow. tremendous. That was tremendous.
If you ever remember when, remember it.
That was fantastic. Yeah. I remember when SmackDown started doing those, and it was all the, like, Scotty Goldman was one of them. I remember fondly.
Yeah.
Scotty Goldman like, did a lot of them. Yeah.
But it was always like the lower card guys, and it was like get to know the lower card guys kind of thing, right? But that's back when SmackDown was like on my network, and I don't think anybody cared anymore.
Nope.
So
and the best part about this, I did not YouTube it.
You did not YouTube it. It's like, real in your mind.
No memory box.
That's
speaking of YouTube.
Fans of wrestling.
Speaking of YouTube.
Can we get to Raw?
Okay.
And the Raw appearance and victory of the WWE Internet
Champion.
Wait. Speaking of YouTube, you were segueing to Zack Ryder.
Yeah.
The Internet Champion.
And not the return to Joey Styles for color commentary?
What?
How have you guys... Are you watching The True Long Island Story?
Apparently I didn't watch the latest then.
Seriously, it's the Ultimate Broski against the Ultimate Warrior with Joey Styles on commentary.
Oh, yes. I think I did see that. Oh, wow. Because
you were jealous of this.
The greatest thing of all time.
Because you were jealous of this. Remember? When?
Oh, the Hulk Hogan wrestle, buddy. Oh, man.
Let me tell you, brother.
Wow. Okay, we stopped at the wrestle buddy.
Yep. we were in awe.
I'm sorry. We're like, oh, you have a wrestle buddy. You don't have just the Hulk Hogan one.
I just have the Hulk Hogan one now.
What's the deal?
Oh, sorry, Zack Ryder's invading.
Oh, Zack Ryder.
Oh, whoa. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show, Zack Ryder!
Yay!
Woo, 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 you know it.
I don't think we can legally do that. Okay. But yeah, Zack Ryder had a match last night on Raw.
A 30-second victory over Michael Cole dressed as Triple H.
You know, I tweeted this last night. I was dead certain that we were going to see a WrestleMania rematch of Triple H versus the Ultimate Warrior, only with Michael Cole as Triple H and Zack Ryder as the Ultimate Broski.
I also want to point out, not only did we get Joey Styles, we got Gene Okerlund on this episode.
Yeah.
For like the biggest, they have to have support of the WWE at this point, or it's just him getting his cam everywhere, I guess. But
no, they
crap.
Have support. They mention it on the shows. It's
they
in
do.
The
they
it's
do.
In the magazine.
Yeah.
They talk
yeah.
about it all the time.
So. I don't know, that's tremendous. I mean, yes. It's the most fun, as wrestling fans, it's the most fun. I mean, because he's a guy he's a wrestler, he's a wrestling fan, and he's not afraid to show it, you know. The Ultimate, have you guys seen, Diva Dirt's been posting these, where they would have, like, they had these with CM Punk, they had them with Dolph Ziggler before, but at these house shows, they'll have these deals where they'll surround the bad guy, and it's like Evan Bourne, John Cena, and they'll be, you know, Zack Ryder, and the reason they're on Diva Dirt is because Beth Phoenix ends up body slamming whatever guy it is. But the last one I watched,
she glam slam Dolph Ziggler.
Glam slam, yes. The last one I watched had him as the ultimate broski at the house show.
Yes.
That's tremendous.
Wow. Well, what happened initially was Cena was getting beat down by, I want to say it was Ziggler, Miz, and someone else. I forget. And then the Ultimate Warriors music hit, and Zack Ryder came out as the Ultimate Broski and cleared out.
Tremendous. This is why I love house shows. I'm sad I missed the one here in Pittsburgh this past week.
Yeah, especially you guys had Mysterio vs. Miz.
Yeah, I heard about that. Mysterio versus Miz. Oh, I heard the report I saw said that Miz really didn't act like he wanted to be there, and it was a really rough match. So, I don't know.
Oh.
But anyways, back to Raw. I thought it was a great show last night. We had a lot of wrestling. Rey Mysterio becoming WWE champion against The Miz in the first match. And then the rematch against John Cena.
He became... At the beginning of Raw, he became the WWE champion.
For the first time ever.
For the first time ever. And at the end of Raw, he lost his first ever championship to John Cena.
Yep. It's too bad all his supporters are little kids, so they can't have a Christian-like revolt on the internet.
True, true.
No, hey, I'm sure the Disney XD message boards blew up, right?
Well, I mean, either he lost it to Cena or he lost it to Alberto Del Rio. Either way, he was losing it last night.
Well, guys, can we recognize that WWE did something that they have never done before last night? Cena, Rey. They've never had a program.
Yeah.
Ever.
There's never a reason
and,
to.
Yeah.
No, little kids' heads exploded.
The beauty of it.
Yeah.
That's the beauty of it, because it's two guys that the older male population love to hate. Like, they boo Cena and Rey mercilessly. And the kids love Cena and Rey. They divided the audience by putting them against themselves.
That was,
kids' heads exploded.
And they had a good match. They had a tremendous
match.
Rey
had two great matches.
Yeah. Chachi, you were commenting on that before the show.
Yeah, he opened Raw with an amazing match against The Miz. And he closed Raw with an amazing match against Cena. And even the announced team acknowledged the fact that Cena didn't throw a single punch.
Yeah, I was kind of half paying attention until they mentioned that. And, you know, again, I was watching it very late after a shoot last night. So, I mean, it ended at like 3 a.m. I dozed off at the beginning and then I heard that, like, Cena hasn't thrown a punch yet. I was like, oh, something's happening here. And it was a great match.
Yeah, it was them back and
forth. I love that Cena didn't throw a punch because Rey is his friend.
Is that because they're
both faces. Yeah. Cena throws punches when he's angry at the guy he's facing.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. And that makes sense. It makes sense. So, I mean, and it was great. I tried so hard to wait till after Raw to see what happened on Twitter and stuff. But a lot of people were very anti last night's Raw, which I don't understand. Because it was a good Raw,
Because the main event was Rey and Cena. Okay. And most of the people who use social media are our age.
Okay.
And they don't really see that. You know what I mean?
Okay.
What bothers me, people who have been, like, friend of the show, Dave Lagana, who's had his hashtag, I Want Wrestling. Lots of people have been using it, like, all over Twitter.
Yeah.
If you didn't like last night's Raw, you should not be allowed to use that hashtag anymore.
Exactly.
Yeah, because we got that.
Even last week's Raw. Last week's Raw was basically WWE's version of an ROH show. It was all wrestling. They were all really good matches and one promo.
And look at SmackDown's been there for a while. That's been matches. And they had a nice long match between Orton and Kane. I'm sorry, Orton and Kane street fight I'm not excited about right out the gate. But that was a good match between those two.
Oh my God, yes it was.
That was good. And then Mark Henry came out. And I'm sorry, you know, we've been down on Mark Henry in the past. But what they're doing with him, they have not monstered him up like this. this well in the past. I don't know what difference it is. They had an interview with him where he's like, yeah, I heard the Big Show and I kind of enjoyed it and I'm going to do it again. And he did it to Kane. It was a really good storyline. It was a really good match leading up into it. It was a good show, you know, and yeah, the I Won Wrestling movement that Lagana started, I don't know if that's a response to this or just it's all kind of, you know, happenstance at the same time. But you're seeing a lot of those tags and a lot of them should be pretty happy what they're seeing. Because, I mean, there's
and yet they don't seem to be.
No, because your problem is these internet smarks, you know, that we, you know, kind of are anti, but we kind of are them too here on this show. They're hijacking it is the problem. And that's going to be an issue as the I Want Wrestling thing gets more popular. So
you're always going to have assholes.
Yeah, you're always going to have assholes.
That's pretty much it.
And the assholes can use the tag just as well as the fans we want to talk with that are enjoying themselves. So
the only thing that I had a problem with was last night's show. Mm-hmm. The only thing that really just kind of lessened the wind in my sails a little bit was
the in-ring activity.
That Ziggler beat Evan Bourne clean, because that means there probably won't be a rematch.
Okay.
Because I would love to see an actual feud between them.
Yeah, yeah.
Because their match last night was awesome.
So you think it was just kind of a throwaway match for storyline's sake?
Yeah, I would like to see.
And that's possible. And it's something, if they tore the house down with it, I think I might have missed it or dozed off during that match, to be honest.
It wasn't a bad match, once again.
Yeah, but that could, you know, when they start to see something like that there's a spark, sometimes they're like, well, let's do this again.
Yeah.
Remember that week they had, was it John Cena and Ziggler, like three shows in a row, like between Raw and SmackDown? That was tremendous.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And, you know, they did that. They had to have done that because the first match did so well. And they're like, well, let's see if we can strike, you know, lightning strikes twice.
Well, that's why they had CM Punk and Rey Mysterio those times, because every match,
kept getting better.
Something different happened.
Really kept getting better.
You got your intention up each and every time.
Yeah, and we were really behind that. That was a really good series.
I would like to see maybe a best of five series of Kofi and Dolph.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I know they've wrestled a lot lately, but
didn't
I think
they
if
do
you
a
do
best
it
of three?
Like the, I think if you do it kind of like the Terry Invitational Tournament, where like each match has a different stipulation and it culminates at SummerSlam, I think that could be really something special.
That could be interesting. That could be interesting. Kind of related.
Just don't make the last match a 2 out of 3 falls.
Yeah.
That is entirely true.
Yeah, yeah.
Because that's a best of 7, not a best of 5.
That'd be a little teenage of them. Yeah, but other than that, great Raw last night. CM Punk coming back. I know a lot of people are... Okay, aside from what you think about how soon it is for him to come back, it was a great show.
Yes.
You were surprised and happy to say that. You didn't say anything. First of all, you said it before the show. I'm not even calling you out. But a lot of people are like that. A lot of the comments are, what is Punk doing back? Come on. But it was a good show.
Well, the reason they're saying that is because everyone is enjoying what he's doing as a non-WWE employee on Twitter and showing up at random events that WWE is out at. And
like Comic-Con?
And the
Comic-Con. Did anybody watch the Comic-Con stuff?
Yeah.
Yes. Amazing.
That's why I thought Ray was going to keep the belt last night.
For those that didn't see, he was at the WWE, Triple H, Bret Hart, Rey Mysterio, at least, were there for the Mattel press conference at Comic-Con, or panel, I guess. And CM Punk came in. And which is interesting, you know, there's been a lot of the fan cam kind of postings, off-air postings on WWE.com, included this Comic-Con spot, included, you know, they showed Punk after the show actually get on the mic and saying, I'm back, and that was about it, but still. And plus, then there was a thing before the last pay-per-view where he sang Chicago.
Chicago.
During a break. You know, during
no,
the commercial
break. He sang it after the cameras were up here.
Okay.
Because that was after he got his mic cut off.
Yeah, I mean, WWE's been really interesting about the way, and maybe I've just noticed it with Punk, probably because he's been the most topical person. But it's an interesting use they're doing over there with WWE.com.
Well, Sorg, they have stuff like that all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they just about every single Raw has an after the camera goes off segment or match or something. Okay. Like, I remember when I was working there and we were logging all the Raw stuff, almost every week for about a year, Stone Cold Steve Austin would propose to Lillian Garcia and douse her with beer. Like, I had one where Rock, Mankind, and Austin were all in the ring shooting the shit with each other.
Yeah.
But they do stuff like that, like, maybe to release it on a DVD of that person, like the Chris Jericho DVD that just came out.
Okay.
Where they had an after Raw bit and an after SmackDown bit, both of which are absolutely hilarious.
Which I always wondered about those, because you always saw, like, there's always, you know, doesn't seem like they do the full production, of course, when Raw goes off the air and they do the dark matches, but they do always have a couple of cameras going.
Oh, yeah. Well, they have to. In case they catch something really good.
Okay. Well, even, you know, like, and I'm sure if they're doing something that's sort of a test match, like, you know, throwing two people together, they're supposed to be in the main event later in the month or something. They're always watching those. There's always critiques, you know. If you're
and especially they'll do it if the end of Raw is a heel dominating.
Yeah,
they'll do the match afterwards with the babyface winning to send the crowd home happy.
Exactly. So, yeah. All right. Anything else from Raw that stuck out?
I don't think it's too early for CM Punk to come back, by the way.
No.
He is white hot right now.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
He's white
gotta
hot.
Gotta push the feud.
Tried
the
hot
it's
hand
the best.
All the way into SummerSlam.
Yeah, and this makes sense for them to build up for SummerSlam. Because I know everybody going into the last thing, they're like, this is really good. This Money in the Bank is, this thing going into this is real good, and I really hope they push it past this. They can't just have him leave or lose and leave. You know, thankfully, he won and he left. And crazy stuff happened. And now we have Triple H in charge. And that is, you know, perfect fodder for them to have him come back, do something at SummerSlam. Hopefully it'll be even better. You know, which we'll see how that goes.
By the way, I could see this leading to CM Punk versus The Undertaker at WrestleMania.
Really?
Yes. I can see it.
How do you connect the dots on that?
Punk being the anti-WWE guy.
Okay.
He could be like, well, I didn't win the Royal Rumble. I didn't win the Elimination Chamber. But there is something I can do that would cement me in the history books forever and ever. And there's nothing that Vince McMahon, Triple H, or anyone can do about it. And that would be the ultimate benefit.
I think he did have a spot with Taker before. So they have worked together, right?
Yeah. They worked together when Hell Punk was Cell. Champion at Hell in the Cell a couple years ago.
Yeah, I remember that, because that's when we're like, that was a really funky finish for a Hell in a Cell, of all things. Mm-hmm.
I know it's not going to happen. I still want to see him in Stone Cold.
Yeah. I don't know. It really feels like it could go to that. Rizz, are you trying to look over my shoulder?
Yes.
Okay. I'm just trying to figure. But and speaking of WrestleMania, did anybody see what Daniel Bryan did? Yes, I see you. I see you, Rizz.
Can you see me?
Oh, jeez.
Wait. Daniel Bryan bury someone yet?
Does anyone
want
to make a bet with me that there's no way Daniel Bryan makes it to WrestleMania with that briefcase?
You think this is where the Mr. Kennedy thing happens? Where, because he's the last one that did this. Granted, it's a little bit less time, but
Well, Kennedy was also a heel, so he didn't believe him anyway.
Yeah, that's true. But you know, they could have done that, you know. If whatever happened with Kennedy didn't happen, you know. He got injured or something, so they had it one off him.
Wait, Mr. Kennedy got injured? Breaking news.
Mr. Injury. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, it takes DNA for us to not care anymore, I guess. Anyways, Bryan Danielson,
that works.
Yeah, okay.
That guy.
he,
American Dragon.
American Dragon. That's a good one. You know, he says he's going to defend it at WrestleMania. Okay. That narrows it down. So there you go.
But
so,
see, the thing that bugs me about that is Cena versus Rock is already kind of, you know, lightly penciled in that it might be a title match.
Okay. Is it?
So is it? Well, yeah. That
yeah,
was
it is.
Plan.
They did mention it like the first few weeks that Cena's going to win the title and face The Rock for the title. I mean, with the title.
Yeah.
On the line.
I see him losing it. I see him losing it. I can't see them doing it. Because what do they do with the Elimination Chamber? What do they do with the Royal Rumble? You know?
Yeah, well, true.
Cena still defends, but you know, his goal is that he wants to go into WrestleMania to defend it against The Rock.
Yeah. Yeah.
But see, that's why I don't think Daniel Bryan is going to make it to Mania.
Okay.
Because Cena already has that kind of penciled in, regardless of whether or not it happens. There's no way that we can have both championship matches set for Mania in July. Especially with the Royal Rumble.
That does make it interesting for booking. So
I mean, unless CM Punk wins the Royal Rumble and WrestleMania becomes a three-way with John, Phil, and Dwayne. And that would be awesome.
That could be interesting. Yeah, I mean, well, especially if Punk's building himself out up with, you know, being a mic guy and everything. Being a Heyman guy, that does kind of represent a different generation than both the other guys do.
Exactly. It's like the new, it'd be like, because Hogan was kind of the guy from the 80s,
yeah.
Rock was the guy from the 90s, Cena is the guy from today, Punk is the guy for tomorrow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he's the this decade guy, so you would have like three decades of WWE represented. Hypothetically, which could make it more interesting. It's a new wrench in there. Cause I mean, you know, a lot of people are like, Rock, John Cena. Yay. Your build. Let's see how this goes. Wasn't there, the Rock said that he mentioned what live event he was going to be at. Is he going to be at SummerSlam?
He said Survivor Series in
Survivor
New York
Series.
City.
New York City. Okay. Going to book my mega bus, for that one. Yes. See if we can get in there and chat.
Yes,
chat Edge
tickets
chance.
Go on sale September 10th.
September 10th.
Mayhem
okay.
Crew is invited.
Yes.
We will get nosebleed seats, and I will yell at Randy Orton fan.
Yes, it was.
Wait, great. Am I invited?
No. You are not.
Fuck
no.
You, Chachi.
You are not.
Well, all right.
Everyone but Rizz.
Aww.
Yay.
And Bobby.
You have to
I'm
have
poor.
Never violated the Mayhem Show wellness policy.
Yes.
It's a lie.
Because you suck.
Can I win a hypothetical trip to New York City?
Sure.
Yay!
There is no winning of trips. The only prize
trip.
You get if you end up here is free room and board.
You know, we could always just buy like four tickets on Megabus and auction them off.
No.
You know.
So, no.
That would be you interesting.
No, because Bobby's, or not Bobby, Rizz isn't allowed to go. He's not invited.
But jeez, the thing is, Thor, they would have to buy their own tickets to Survivor Series.
Yes, we'll get you a part away there. You could scalp the tickets.
Nope.
Where that's what you have to have when you're a budget podcast trying to do prizes.
And, nope. You know, if Bobby comes up, we'll have Madison Square Garden chant Louis Anderson.
No, I knew it was coming. No.
Nope. Bobby's
well,
not coming.
Nope. If I come.
I'm not coming now. You hurt my feelings.
If I come, don't be
hyped
through.
This is taking such a turn. Hey, I know what'll cheer everybody up. How's TNA doing these days?
Fuck yeah.
TNA made a really good decision this week, Sorg.
That is true.
What's that?
They signed friend of the show, Shima Zion.
It's great for him. Everybody knows who Zima Ion is now. And wait a minute. You know, I don't know if I mentioned here on the show, but it's a double-edged thing. It's like, great, you know, friend of the show, somebody, you know, we've seen, you know, doing really cool stuff locally and around the world. It gets signed to TNA. It's a breakthrough for him.
Now he can
but
get forgotten
poor
about.
Poor guy, you know.
Now Abyss can kill him.
yeah, is it, you know, is he going to get janiced? Is he going to be, you know, on food stamps because he's at TNA and can't get other proper bookings? I'm worried because he's supposed to be in a major match with IWC for Cage Fury. Is that going to run into anything? Because TNA's been real bad about pulling people like that, you know.
Sorg. Why? I was trying to cheer people up.
I know.
But it's the Mayhem bump, Sorg.
You gotta be real.
Yeah.
Gotta be real.
But
we have the possibility of having Shima Zion versus Eric Young for the television championship.
Oh man. And you know, I'm curious to see what they do with them. What parts of you know, some of his personality he's done in the indies is going to come through? Are they going to do something really different and weird? I don't know. It could be interesting. It really could.
Question totally off topic.
No.
Okay.
Bobby doing a copyright infringement?
No, they were sitting here. Everybody else had glasses on. I felt left out.
We do all have glasses on. We are the Four Eyes Mayhem show.
What the hell? What up?
Okay. All right, yeah, my future's so bright, I gotta wear shades.
Wait.
Where are you going?
My bag, right here.
Where is he going?
Chachi leaves.
What's Chachi doing?
I have no idea. He just walked away again. I went for his bag. Oh.
Chachi, the indie minute's over. Come back.
I see what's gonna happen.
Oh, no.
Alright, let me know how that
Did
is.
Did Chachi pull out his penis?
Back. You ready?
Again.
Alright, there he is. Now everybody can see the other side of the studio in your glasses. Yep.
What up? I'm mad, Mike. I'm angry.
It's not a segment.
It's an in-ring activity.
You watch that on YouTube.
You know what? You guys can get a fucking hotel. How about that? And Josh, you owe me some goddamn curtains.
I need you to measure the windows so I know what size to buy you.
I need you to just give me money. I'll get my own goddamn curtains.
All right, that's fine.
How many years is that? That's from Royal Rumble weekend, wasn't it?
Yeah.
When John Cena came back.
I spilt Pepsi.
You kid?
Mayhem show brings people together. Anyways,
hey, we got fucking hammered that weekend.
We did, man.
You guys threw a baby seat down a flight of stairs.
No, it was not. Let me clarify this. Because
there wasn't a baby in it.
No, there was no
baby in it.
All right, first off, there was no baby. Good. There's no baby involved at all.
Tweet him if you have questions about that.
But it was not a baby seat.
It was a baby swing.
When I say it was a car seat, I mean it was the full size fucking car from seat from a car.
Fair enough.
Like it was a 100% real life bucket seat from like a wannabe Too Fast, Too Furious car that we picked up. We tossed it over the cement barricades and just watched it tumble down the stairs.
Man, you guys were nuts.
That's what happens when I get hammered, run back to a bar for Chad, and don't get into the bar.
Did you, like, not have shoes on or something?
Yeah, I didn't have shoes on.
You were really eager to go rescue Chad.
I was.
I got to rescue Chad. The show is up somewhere. I don't know what episode that is.
I don't care.
Oh, yeah, I didn't remember that.
I looked to it randomly and say, to hear my sister say that her roommate has herpes.
We need to find that show. I don't know what episode that is. I have no idea.
Hold on. All right. You guys talk. I will look it up.
Okay.
But
all right. Anyways.
Yeah. No. If you can go to New York for a pay-per-view.
Everybody stay at
Mad Mike's. And stay at Mad Mike's house.
Wait, did you just invite everybody to stay at Mad Mike's house?
Mike's going to have like 25,000 people.
This is going to be awesome.
I was talking about the crew.
Okay.
The crew.
You look like you're on drugs now.
You don't have to buy a hotel. That guy has an apartment. Let's stay there.
I'm Jim Morrison. Or John Morrison. John Morrison.
I think you're right the first time.
I don't know if I can have everyone here.
No, we just invited the entire audience.
Yeah. But I mean, all right. Let's see.
Lucky for you or not, I want wrestling.
Let's recap what I learned from that weekend in
New York. Bam Show 115 is 115. The Mayhem Takes Manhattan Spectacular.
Oh my god.
But every fifth drink in New York is free.
I don't think that's like a town rule.
Actually,
if you have tits, it's every third drink.
We went to two bars, all right?
Oh, the
and every bar. Fifth drink was free.
Does that carry over from the previous bar?
No.
Okay.
Because all right, we went to Brother Jimmy's, and what was it?
We're not talking about wrestling anymore.
Two of the fish bowls we didn't have to pay for because we ordered so many of them. All right.
He has the point, yeah.
Because I walked in, I remember paying for the Jack and Coke that I mistakenly ordered before I found out that was the fishbowl bar.
Okay.
And then the fishbowl. And I remember there was two people with us that didn't have to pay for the fishbowls.
Because they had tits?
No, because our group ordered so many of them. And then we went to Fenwick's.
I do believe there were two people with tits there, though.
Yeah. And then we went to Fenwick's. And
were they the good kind of tits?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, one's my sister, so it's the off-limits kind of tits.
Ah, okay.
But, then we went to Fenwick's, and honestly, every fifth drink I didn't pay for. And we drank a lot.
That's because Fenwick's is awesome.
I know.
And the good thing about Survivor Series being in my city, the college-age women will be on campus and will be at my local bar. So,
score.
Please, if you are going to come up to Mad Mike's fabulous palatial estate, make sure you're 21 years of age. Sorry, WrestleFan.
Memory boxed.
What?
I don't know. What? I just like the term memory box.
He can just YouTube what happened.
Wow. You guys all remember right. when I watched that on YouTube?
But, my favorite part was forgetting that New York doesn't do last call until 4. Because at 2 o'clock, I'm rushing, or like a quarter to 2, I'm rushing up to the bar to get two more drinks to last me until they finally kick us out. And then 2 o'clock came around, I'm like, oh.
Yeah, I remember you came back, and I'm like, why are you double-fisting? And you're like, well, I wanted to beat last call. I'm like, dude, it's only 2. Some people are just getting here.
Yeah. I no offense to Mad Mike. I mean, I love New York City. But for me, it's one of those places that I visit, get shit-faced, and then leave.
That wasn't what you were saying when you were here.
No, you wanted to live there.
Yeah,
like,
I know.
I'm going to New York.
You were telling me that you could pay half the rent really easily.
Yes. You're like, I'll find a job.
I could. I still could.
Oh, man. Yeah, you got to love New York. I've enjoyed the Royal Rumble we went to at the Hammerstein for Ring of Honor. I mean, between New York and Philly, those are the towns to go to. No matter where you live, you need to make that drive, the bus trip, the plane trip, once in your life to go to a big show, you know, Hammerstein, MSG, ECW Arena. Is there really any place else you need to go?
We are going to be papering that city with WMS stickers.
Blair County Convention Center. If you don't go there, you're not a man.
What?
to the man poke.
Yeah, yeah. But, no, okay, Chicago is probably the only other one I can think of for you.
And Toronto.
Okay, our list is getting a lot longer. Okay.
That's what she said.
No, if you're going to go to a big city to watch a wrestling show,
mm-hmm.
honestly, it has to be New York, and it has to be
that
MSG.
That is the place.
Exactly.
That is the Mecca.
If you're
going
to take a trip for a wrestling show,
mm-hmm.
You take the trip to New York City to Madison Square Garden.
Hey, that is one of my goals.
Can I double check with you, Mad Mike? What episode was that again?
115.
115.
Because 115 is coming up from the DJ Lunchbox Cave.
Oh.
From the LB Cave.
I count, maybe it's 116? It's around there. It's right around there.
Okay. Okay. Oh, you were applying math to this. Come on, man.
Yes.
Chocolate cake. No.
Excuse me. Chocolate cake. Excuse me. On my feed, you didn't have show... Oh, no wonder. You like reset the number of shows.
What's wrong with you?
Seriously, I have episode 111 on 12/18, 2007. And then Mayhem Takes Manhattan on 1/28/2008. And then you have another WMS 111 on my birthday in 2008.
Wow.
So that's on you, Sorg. That is on you.
But
we
could
be
Sorg
at 300 right now.
Countdown.
Wow.
10, 11, just, 10, just... 9, 8.
It's a conspiracy.
Just
and
walking,
that's the truth.
Just walking into Madison Square Garden is electric.
Mm-hmm.
Because, I mean, if you're
looks so stoned right now.
If you're a sport, it's like sunglasses.
I know, but it just looks like you're like, go there.
If you're a sports fan of any capacity, then that's someplace you just have to go.
Mm-hmm.
Hands down.
Pants off.
Yes.
Pants off, dance off.
Rock out.
I hear there's a lot of tickets available for the Knicks game.
Rock out.
Actually, Knicks tickets are pretty difficult to get.
Rock out.
Even when they suck.
Out.
All right, now that we've diverged a little bit, tell us, guys, what else should we be talking about from wrestling this past year?
This past year?
This past year?
Wow. This past week.
Woo, what did you learn from the year, folks?
We're in review show.
We're going to do it.
Jump in a little bit. Yeah. yes.
Stephanie McMahon has CM Punk's number.
Oh, yes. There's that from the Comic-Con.
Did you see the CM Punk on Jimmy Kimmel Live segment they did?
No, but I was being told about it before the show.
Yeah, I sent you it on Twitter.
Okay.
It was pretty good. They had Cousin Sal's son. He's a huge John Cena fan, and he was like yes. He was like talking to his dad about John Cena, and all of a sudden CM Punk walks through the door, has a championship belt, and just like berates this kid. It's pretty funny. Yeah, check it out.
Awesome.
That's great.
Hey, guys, I've ever noticed, like, for the past month, the whole show that we've done is about CM Punk in some aspect.
Well,
that's the entire show.
Yep.
Well, when you do a good job, you give us lots of positive things to talk about.
That's right. That's true.
You do a really bad job.
Yes.
TNA.
What? Well, how many shows have we done where we just berated TNA for an hour and a half?
That's true.
I'm sure they were very enthralling.
But
I think that was half of my appearances here.
Yeah. You bring the negativity. What's up, Chachi?
Yes.
On the stories of CM Punk's and things that he's doing, I want wrestling posted the history of CM Punk, or the story of CM Punk almost getting left behind in WWE,
mm-hmm.
because he was a Heyman guy,
mm-hmm.
and it's really interesting.
The Heyman
stuff.
Guy has been the greatest meme I think they've ever done.
It's a really great story, and basically it came down to Shawn Michaels being like, hey, we're all getting old, so give the kid a shot.
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Like, originally he was supposed to make Big Show tap out in the first Elimination Chamber he was in, but all of the agents were against him. So they're like, no. And they changed everything. Like, everyone was on board for it. Big Show was willing to tap out. CM Punk was willing to put him in the Anticon device. And then all the agents are just like, no, that's not happening.
But John Laurinaitis, who she is, said no.
Yep. Punched in the face.
Guys.
Yes.
Guys.
Yes.
Zack Ryder is going to be regularly on TV.
About
what?
Time.
What?
I'm just reading this. If you want to see Zack Ryder, watch SmackDown this week.
Did he get traded?
No, he's probably going to bounce back and forth.
No, it seems like Zack Ryder is going to be permanently on SmackDown.
Well, good. Good for him. I mean, it's if he's going to be doing stuff, I mean, if they're not finding room for him on Raw, go ahead and let him experiment and do matches on SmackDown.
They should let him
he's
fight
been doing
Kofi.
Superstars. Let him fight Kofi. Yeah. You think that'd be good?
Yeah.
I mean, Kofi's on Raw. I went nuts when he came out for Cole.
I know.
That was good.
It doesn't matter who he comes out for.
Yeah.
They're going to go nuts.
All right. Well, is there anything else we need to get to before we head out of here, guys?
Balls.
Okay.
TNA sucks.
That's great. All right, let's go ahead over.
Hold on. The one good thing on TNA this week is Austin Aries.
I'll be honest. I didn't. I only caught the end of TNA this week, or else I'd have a little more to say about it. But that's.
Chachi, you betrayed me.
Man. There was a good ladder match on TNA this week, too.
Cool.
It was a four-way ladder match with Matt Morgan, Joe, AJ, and I want to say Crimson or Gunner, one of them.
Gunner. I think it was Gunner.
Yeah, people. Gunner. You know what? And I really don't think TNA's done that bad after the pay-per-view. You know, we had the email to the contrary. I think they've been very watchable. I've enjoyed watching the show.
It's because of the Bound for Glory series.
Okay.
And
yeah.
If they can keep this going, it's a great concept.
Yeah.
But the Sting stuff is really kind of difficult to watch.
Yeah.
Kind of difficult?
Or a little bit.
Like extremely difficult.
I wish Sting would pick a Joker imitation and pick
like, Cesar Romero.
I wish Sting would buy a couch he likes.
What?
I my new theory is that Sting keeps wrestling because he doesn't like his couch.
Okay.
If he bought a couch he liked, he would retire and just sit on his couch. Like he should do.
Please donate.
He and buy the fold-out Sting bed. Couch.
Yes. Please send
in
us
the couch of the singer.
Please send us money so we can buy Sting a nice big comfy couch.
Is that what you learned this week?
Yeah.
Okay. That's good.
Is it a good one?
Yeah.
I can come up with more.
Is everyone okay with this?
I heard he was over as a face, but I didn't know they made him one.
Oh, there goes my idea. He's a face now.
Okay. Well, what'd you learn from wrestling this week, Mad Mike?
He just told you, Sheamus is a face. Move on.
I thought that was just a reaction. All right, Bobby.
Hey, that wasn't what I learned. I was asking if everyone was okay with it.
You know, it's like that three wishes. I'm sorry, you just used two of them.
Fuck you. I wish for 18 more wishes.
You learned that we were okay with that.
You only get one I learned. Hey, what'd you learn? Come on.
I learned that wrestling, that Raw has, like, WWE in general, has been really good for the past month and a half, and people need to stop shitting on it. Because I think this is the new Attitude Era, and I think we can call it the Internet Era.
Okay. Okay.
Because everyone's on Twitter, they're pushing, Rock and Cena are pushing their storyline on Twitter, because Rock doesn't want to show up to TV.
Mm-hmm.
Zack Ryder is one of the biggest things on YouTube.
Top 100.
His show is blowing up. He was on top 100 on CNN SI's people to follow on Twitter. CM Punk has been blowing up the internet by invading Comic-Con, going to an independent show. The Miz is the number one in the PWI 500, and he's been all over social media. This is the internet era. It's the WWE finally taking the internet, and instead of working against it, using it.
Wow.
This internet thing's pretty cool, huh?
Is that what you learned this week,
God
Chase?
God damn you, Bobby.
Bobby, what'd you learn
nope,
from us?
That's what
week?
Bobby learned. Moving on.
I learned. Hey, head to Chachi.
Hey, Rizz, what'd you learn?
Cut his mic off! Cut his mic off!
Oh. And about this bully thing. Sorg preaches about being a bully and
we don't have an anti-bullying campaign here. We bully WrestleFan all the time.
Actually, about this wellness policy, Sorg preaches it and then that's what I should have done.
Oh, now you killed the kayfabe.
Anyways, yeah. the thing that I learned this week, they need to start getting, like, I had an idea. Now that Sheamus is a face, the idea is, like, shot, pretty much. But I don't think it would ever happen anyways. But they need to get some of these younger guys over that are, like, Drew McIntyre, Sheamus. I know we all hate him, but Mason Ryan, mm-hmm. Wade Barrett.
I don't hate him. He just looks a lot. Yeah,
I mean, he's not that great, but you know, they could hide him in a stable. I think they need a mouthpiece, and I think that could be William Regal.
Managers, we need managers.
Because he's not really doing much right now, and he's excellent on the mic, and you can have like an all European stable,
so something like that, or Roddy Piper. Stable.
Yeah, bring the back stables.
Okay.
So bring back William Regal?
Yeah, bring back William Regal. I support William Regal.
And bury him!
And bury him!
Bury him!
Rizz, Anderson.
What'd you learn from wrestling this week?
Well, first I learned that it's awesome to be back. And thank you, WrestleFan, for doing drugs and having me on this show.
Yeah, that's all the time we have this week for the Wrestling Mayhem show.
No, see, Rizz took his spot. Rizz took his spot, not his dog spot.
Wow. I wouldn't think
Chuck. Spot on the carpet. He took WrestleFan's spot.
Wow.
WrestleFan's spot.
That's a cool thing.
Wait, does that mean we all have to bang Rizz's mom now?
Oh.
I want to thank Pop Rocks.
I guess so.
All right. Dibs.
Dip. Whoa.
All yours, big guy. All yours.
I just hope Rizz's mom.
Well, no, we all have to do it. I just call dibs on going first.
I think, I just hope Rizz's mom.
She hasn't listened to the show. Don't worry.
I just hope Rizz's mom isn't nicknamed Pop Rocks.
Shit.
Don't combine her with soda.
Yeah.
We're gonna see a Twitter account come up, Pop Rocks IUP.
Oh no.
I won't go there.
What are you doing, Chacha? Where'd you find that?
It was down here with the prizes.
Oh.
It shows you the complete list of all the series of the toys.
Nice.
And I thought it was funny because in the first series, like in the first release of the series, Rey Mysterio's in release number 2. In the second one, he's in release number 2. But in the third one, they bumped him to number 3 and put Hornswoggle on number 2.
Oh.
So they replaced a midget with a midget.
Oh, and my local Toys R Us was out of Zack Ryder figures.
Oh.
I wanted to buy one.
Down here, they have a complete collection with him as the Flash.
Yes.
Sorry.
Oh, actually, at Comic-Con, they had a whole bunch of different Rey Mysterios. Like, they had concept people from Mattel come up with different Rey Mysterio figures, and there was a Doink Mysterio, there was a Steampunk Mysterio, there were a whole bunch of different types. You can look up Comic-Con pictures from Mattel to see what they had.
That's another thing. Did anybody see the Cody Rhodes Comic-Con segment?
Yes.
That was awesome, too.
Brilliant.
The action figures with the little bags on their heads.
Oh, I need to see that.
It was really good.
Awesome.
That sounds
awesome.
Good. I need to see that.
So, Sorg.
Sorgatron.
Sorg, what did you learn from wrestling this week?
Oh, me. I learned.
What did you learn?
Oh, geez, what did I learn?
Oh, time's up. So, to contact us, you can email us at...
Whoa!
WrestlingMayhem.com. Follow us on Twitter
You can follow us on Twitter, like us on Facebook. Take care, spike your hair, drink your whiskey.
Go ahead.
Deer drugs. Wait. No.
Take care. Don't. Spike your hair. Down Pop Rocks and soda.
And say your prayers, brother.
I learned that Pop Rocks can be a hurtful addiction. And some people can't do
DJ
a podcast because
better.
Of them. He's too busy. He's at home, laid out on his bed with Pop Rocks popping in his mouth, hanging out of his mouth.
I once knew stripper.
I'm sorry. You can't eat an entire case of Pop Rocks at a time. Your head might explode. Okay?
Is it too early to say that we should have gone to rehab?
No.
Come on, guys. No. Addiction's not funny.
Anyways, on that note. Hey, from the
By
Facebook.
The way, stay tuned after the credits for the trailer for Mayhem Avengers.
Yes.
I put no Chachi does not throw babies down the stairs on the Facebook during the show. Austin says lies, all lies. Kyle says just throw WrestleFan down the stairs. He's technically not a baby.
Oh!
And that's why you need to respond to us on Facebook, on Twitter. We're at, no, that's me. That's, I'm at Sorgatron. At Mayhem Show, WrestlingMayhemShow.com. You can check us out. Email us at
Good times
at WrestlingMayhemShow.com.
At bad times.
That's 412-206-WMS0. And, and then while you're at it, you know, check out the Mayhem Show app. Check out, if you go to SorgatronMedia.com, we have a new Sorgatron Media weekly newsletter, mailing list. Sign up for it so you can find out every Monday it'll drop in your mailbox. And we'll also let you know about contests. We have prizes. Chachi's reading them one right now over there. So stay tuned.
We have an ultra super special prize coming up for the winner of the Mayhem Fantasy Football League.
Right there.
Hypothetical penis.
What?
All kinds of stuff. Please check us out at the Baltimore Comic Con coming up in August, the weekend of the 20th. And more information will be over there at SorgatronMedia.com. Also, PodCampPittsburgh.com coming up in September. Nine. We'll be doing a live awesome cast from there with Chachi and
there
some
are
other
10
people.
Different John
Chachi
Cena action
still
figures
all over this stuff.
On this
so,
thing.
For the crew, the replacement crew, the fan
You're
crew.
All replaceable.
That's right. Nobody's bigger for the Mayhem Show.
We're all just cogs in the wheel of the Mayhem Machine.
That's right. See you guys next week. Just wait. Just wait. Just wait. Just wait.